Hey Asher, good afternoon Internet. Today is Wednesday, October 5th, and this is Collaboratory's fourth video blog. My name is Sam Farmer, and if this is your first time watching, you should check out our other devlogs when this one's done. Now Asher, I'd like to discuss cheating. Hopefully this won't get too philosophical or ethical, but first, a story. There was a game show back in the 50s called 21. Here's how the game worked. First, a category was revealed, and then contestants got to pick questions ranging from a point value of 1 to 11, 11 being the most difficult. The point of the game was to get 21 before your opponent did. If you were the champion and you got 21, then you got to stay on the show. If you were the challenger and you got 21, you got to throw the champion off of their throne and become the next champion in the next week. What's interesting about that? Here's the interesting part. The show was wildly successful, especially when America was rooting for the charismatic champion. The game designers realized this, and they basically rigged the game. Showrunners were feeding answers to the contestant in the booth. Effectively, it was a well-paid acting gig. Everybody wins, right? Right? Wrong. They couldn't keep it up. Eventually, it all came crumbling down. So what did we learn from this fiasco? Cheating tarnishes the victories of other players. It also tarnishes the creators, the host, and the network, like everyone involved. And the audience feels downright violent towards the creators. I mean, it's just entertainment, right? I don't usually get angry at a TV drama when it jumps the shark. I just stop watching it. Except for Lost. There's something about these games that really hit us. So cheating is a big deal even when it's meant to make everyone happier. Contestants were making some sort of guaranteed money. Showrunners were making a lot of money. The audience was entertained. How does this have to do with Spacetronauts? I'll tell you. Multiplayer games equals cheating. So in Spacetronauts, we have to be very, very balanced and even with our players. Part of the appeal of playing games with people, for me, is that you'll all start out on equal footing. It can be skill-based, it can be luck-based, but it won't be based on how much you sucked last week. There's an equality to that. For instance, if you're cheating at poker in certain circumstances, I could shoot you with my revolver. I don't currently own a revolver, but if I lived in the Wild West, you bet I would. Back in the day, that was fair game, or so I'm told. For very serious games like poker, cheating equaled death. This example is somewhat relevant to Spacetronauts because it's about the frontier. In a video game and in the modern world in general, players can't really do that. All you can do is leave and never come back. So Asher, as game makers, we've got to be that sheriff. In a frontier town of potentially thousands of cheaters. So Asher, I hope your time traveling neutrinos can help out here because I think we're going to need a lie detector, 3 packs of root beer, a quantum tunneling router to keep our players honest. Here's a roundabout way of saying, Spacetronauts is not a quiz show and you're not going to have to worry about cheating.